Well, you don't have to go to Hollywood to hit the red carpet.
The Central Virginia Film Institute is proud to host this year's Oscar Experience. And 8 News anchor Avajoy Burdette's live in Petersburg at a red carpet event, but it's not any red carpet event, right, Avajoy?
That is right, Juan. Good evening, Juan and Christina. This right here at Union Train Station in Petersburg is one of only 47 officially Oscar-sponsored events all across the country. So what do you get when you go to an official Oscar event? One of these. This is one of those Oscar books with all sorts of stats on some of the nominees for tonight and so forth. This event is for a good cause. But before we tell you what that good cause is all about, we're going to give you a behind-the-scenes look at what it takes to set up an event like this. There's a glitz and glam of the red carpet and reminders that Hollywood has recognized Petersburg.
2 years ago, we were talking about bringing more film activity to this region. And in the meantime, Steven Spielberg found that this is where he wanted to film his film Lincoln.
But nothing is complete without food. So folks have been working for hours to make this Oscar event by the Virginia Film Institute perfect. But all of this work is for young people who dream of Hollywood but don't know how to get there.
We just feel it's a need within this community and the region for that matter, for people to be able to come to some place and to learn the basics of being successful in the performing arts.
So about 10 years ago, Frank Underwood, Blair Underwood's father, started the Central Virginia Film Institute. Tonight's event is a fundraiser to provide programs for anyone young or old interested in the film industry. And on this night where Hollywood's best are rewarded, it's also a reminder of where dreaming can get you.
I'm a firm believer in dreams and in pursuing your dream, but realizing it takes a lot of hard work and willingness to endure failure to reach to get to the top.
Well, you saw how nice it looks inside. Behind me, you can see there are people walking onto the red carpet to go inside. There's paparazzi, all the glitz and glam. I wanted to get an idea of how much it would cost anyone to get into an event like this. It's $85 per ticket. There's also a silent auction. All of that money will be going to the Central Virginia Film Institute, and then that money will in turn go back into the community to help people with film camps and also an academy that will be coming later this year. Reporting live in Petersburg at an official Oscar event, I'm Avajoy Burnette, 8 News.
All right.
You did not have to go to the red carpet tonight all the way to Hollywood. The Central Virginia Film Institute hosted this year's Oscar Experience.
And 8 News anchor Avajoy Burnette is down there live for us tonight with an update on the festivities here locally. Avajoy?
Hey there, good evening, guys, or maybe I should be saying good morning right now. I am standing inside the Union train station in Petersburg, where earlier tonight, easily about 200 people packed this area. Right now, you can still see there's still a few people here mingling. It was one of 47 official Oscar parties in the country, but it was special for more reasons than just one. Folks paid $85 each.
Well, all the lights.
Just to get a piece of the Hollywood experience.
Camera extravagance.
Tonight was all about celebrating the Oscars and the fact that Hollywood has recognized Petersburg.
I had the opportunity to come to Petersburg and see the historic sites, and it is very humbling to understand that this is where it all began.
The crowd was rooting for their hometown movie, Lincoln, to win big. But the most important goal for tonight was to raise money for the Central Virginia Film Institute, an organization that supports and encourages young people who have their eyes on Hollywood.
The arts are very important. They're important for our kids to have another form of outlet, another form of expression other than just sports.
Colonel Frank Underwood, Blair Underwood's father, helped to start the Institute about 10 years ago, and he has a message for young people who one day want to make it to Hollywood's biggest stage.
We only have one life. And I think we need to make it worthwhile, and the way to make that worthwhile, I think, is achievement of your dreams.
All right. Well, on a side note, I wanted to let you guys know that our own 8 News anchor Amy McLean emceed tonight's event. And the Central Virginia Film Institute has big things coming up for this year. I am told they are planning on opening a film academy. Now I'm here with a bunch of people who are going to wish you guys a good night. And we'll see when we get back for everybody else. Have a good night. Reporting live in Petersburg, I'm Avajoy Burnette, 8 News.
Central Virginia, though, hosted one of just 47 official watch parties across the nation last night, and I had the honor of being the MC for the third year in a row. More than 200 folks came out to last night's event in Petersburg, many of them, of course, rooting for Steven Spielberg's Lincoln, which was filmed in the city. The main focus, though, was to raise money to support the Film Institute.
The arts are very important. They're important for our kids to have another form of outlet, another form of expression other than just sports.
We only have one life, and I think we need to make it worthwhile, and the way to make that worthwhile, I think, is achievement of your dreams.
It was a wonderful evening. A silent auction also helped to raise funds for the Central Virginia Film Institute. And one last note, 8 News happy to be a sponsor for the Central Virginia Film Institute Oscar Experience. I had the chance to host again this year. This is a lovely plaque that they presented to me just for being a part of the event. Lots of folks came out dressed in their Hollywood best. And of course, we were all rooting for Lincoln.
Daniel Day-Lewis won.
He did.
That's a yay.
Yay.
All right, we're back in 25 minutes with an update. We'll see you then.